Hi, my name is Tom Croxton, and I am a branch chief in the Division of Lung Diseases of the NHLBI. There are 16 million people in the United States who have been diagnosed with COPD. That's obviously a lot of people. 16 million is about two times the population of New York City. Millions more who actually do have COPD are not aware of it. They have not yet been diagnosed. So the total number of people who have COPD is probably more than 16 million, perhaps 20 to 30 million. COPD is much more common among people with a history of cigarette smoking. That fact led to our understanding that cigarettes can cause COPD, and that has driven a lot of our research about the biological basis of this disease. But there are a lot of other associations, and we are just now beginning to understand why certain risk factors are associated with the disease. For example, COPD becomes more common as people get older. And NHLBI-supported researchers are very interested in studying how the biology of aging intersects with the pathogenesis of COPD. Other risk factors may give us additional clues that eventually lead to better treatments for this disease. COPD is more common in certain parts of the country, generally the Mississippi and Ohio River valleys and the southeastern part of the country. Some of this may be explained by smoking, but there may be other contributors as well. COPD is now more common among women than among men. For the last several years, more women have died of COPD than have men. There also appear to be racial and ethnic differences. COPD is less common among Hispanics, but seems to be much higher among American Indians and Alaska Natives. There may be important genetic factors that predispose certain people to get COPD. We've known about one for some time now, a condition called alpha-1 antitrypsin deficiency. Better understanding how fine particles in the air and noxious fumes can cause COPD may help us to understand the causation of this disease in Americans who have never smoked. In fact, 20 to 25% of COPD in the U.S. may occur in never smokers. So if you have symptoms of lung disease, such as cough or shortness of breath, even if you've never smoked, talk to your healthcare provider about it. Learn more about COPD. Visit copd.nhlbi.nih.gov.